I would like to play a little tune I just composed not so long ago.
Miss Billie Holiday.
Say the mother, bringing us back again from the drumming on the Congo. Came with a strong flow and continued to grow. Feet moved to the beat of the tabalo. Now dig the story and follow, for then it landed on American soil. Through the sweat, the blood, and the toil, it praised the Lord, shouted on chain gangs. Pain it felt, but it helped them to maintain. Scott Joplin grass, Bessie Smith's blues, St. Louis blues, they were all the news, ringing smooth in all the listeners' ears, fulfilling the needs and planting the seeds of a jazz band. King Oliver's group was a train coming through to Chicago, bringing a New Orleans groove. And with Satchmo Blue, the audience knew Basin Street Blues was the whole house tune. It was music great to dance to, great to romance to, with a lot to say to you, relaying a message, revealing the essence of a jazz band. The real bebop. So let me talk about Diz and Bird, giving the word, defining how a beat could be so complete. Playing with ferocity, thinking with velocity about ornithology or anthropology, and even epistrophe. And this is real history. Thelonious Monk, a melodious thunk. No mistakes were made with the notes he played. His conception was recondite, a star glowing bright among dim lights. The critics did cite that he sounded all right. Charlie Mingus, such nimble fingers, dropping the bass all over the place. And Max Roach, cymbal socking, bass drum talking, snare drum rocking, restructuring the metaphysics of a jazz thing.